If you want to download the latest Gen 4 from its homepage, you may be confused by so many download buttons on this page. You can download three types of things from this page: source files, data files, and pre-compiled libraries. If you are new to Gen 4, you should download the last option on this page, a simple installer that can be double-clicked and run. I've made another video to explain in detail how to install pre-compiled Gen 4 libraries on a Windows machine. If it is absolutely necessary for you to use some of the optional Gen 4 features, such as the Qt graphic user interface, which is not included in the pre-compiled libraries, you will have to download the Gen 4 source code and compile it by yourself. As a Windows user, please download the source code in a zip file, which can be handled by Windows without installing extra software. Let's open the folder where the downloaded zip file is located. Right-click on it, choose Extract All, and press Extract. There's no special requirement on the location of the extracted Gen 4 source code. I simply put it into my user's downloads folder. It is absolutely okay for you to extract it to other folders such as desktop or documents, as long as you don't have to use the administrator privilege to write to it. If you open the extracted folder, you will find nothing that you can click and run. What should we do next? According to the Gen 4 installation guide, the easiest way to build and install Gen 4 from source on Windows platforms is to use the Windows command line program command plus CMake's command line interface. This is actually not necessary. CMake in Windows provide a perfect graphic user interface for you to click through. There is no need for you to type in any command. So our next step is to go to the CMake homepage and download the latest CMake. A simple installer is what we need. We don't need the source code of CMake. Let's double click on the CMake installer. Click Next. Accept the agreement. I prefer to add CMake to the system path for possible command line usage. Now we can open CMake GUI to prepare Gen 4 source code for compiling. In the previously extracted Gen 4 source code folder, you can find a file named CMake lists. Drag this file into the CMake window to tell CMake where the Gen 4 source code is located. CMake will create a lot of files to prepare Gen 4 source code for the compilation. It is normally a good idea to create a dedicated directory called build to contain those automatically generated files so that they won't get mixed up with the original Gen 4 source code. If the build directory does not exist, when you click the configure button, CMake will ask your permission to create one. In the next window, CMake asks you to specify the generator for this project. The default choice is the latest Visual Studio 2019. If you don't have it installed in your machine, you will have to go to the Visual Studio homepage to download the free community edition of it and install it. Visual Studio is a huge program. It takes a lot of time to download and install it. We will not go through it in this short video. However, since it's a very popular program, you should be able to find a lot of tutorials on YouTube that can guide you through the process step by step. One thing I want to emphasize though is the installation of C++ support in Visual Studio. This is because Gen 4 is written in C++. Without C++ support, Visual Studio cannot be used to compile Gen 4. At some point, During the installation process of Visual Studio, you will be asked to select the workloads or feature sets. Make sure that you select Desktop Development with C++. If you already have Visual Studio installed on your machine and you are not so sure whether you have C++ enabled in it, you can click on the Tools menu, select Get Tools and Features. The Workloads selection window will be brought up one more time for you. Select Desktop Development with C++ if you haven't done so. Now let's go back to CMake and finish the selection of Visual Studio as the generator for the compilation of Jiang 4. After the configuration, you should be able to see a list of options that you can modify. You would also see a warning message in red in the window below asking you to set Jiang 4 install data variable to on so that the datasets listed on the Jiang 4 webpage can be installed automatically. So let's just follow this instruction and check Jiang 4 install data option. You may also want to change the option CMake install prefix. The default value of it is in C program files. You need the administrator privilege to write to this directory. I'd rather change it to my personal user directory where I can modify without switching to the administrator account. And finally, we'd like to delete unnecessary CMake configuration types. Release is the only thing we need here. Now let's click Generate to create files needed by Visual Studio for the compilation of Jiang 4. When the generating process is done, the Open Project button is enabled. Click on it to launch the Visual Studio with the CMake generated Jiang 4 solutions loaded. Click on Build and select Build Solution or simply press F7 to start the build process of a Jiang 4. At the very beginning, this process is trying to download Jiang 4 data files and extract them into your local hard disk. It takes very long to compile the whole Jiang 4 source code. Now it's time to go and grab a cup of coffee to reward yourself for having achieved so much. With a 4-core 3rd generation Intel i7 processor, it took me about an hour to reach the end of the compiling process. We can see that 46 solutions were successfully built, and the libraries are created in the build directory specified in CMake. That's good. However, there are 4 skipped solutions, and one of them is called install, which means that we finished the compilation of our Jiang 4 source code, but we haven't installed it in the directory specified by the CMake install prefix. This is not because we did something wrong, but because Jiang 4 is configured to not build this solution automatically. Now let's scroll down the solution list, find the install solution, right-click on it, and select Build to copy the compiled Jiang 4 libraries from the build directory to the install directory. First, the downloaded Jiang 4 data is copied from the build directory to the install directory. At the end of the installation process, the Jiang 4 examples are copied to the shared subdirectory in the installation folder. The libraries are copied to the bin subdirectory in the installation folder. There are only 4 subdirectories in the Jiang 4 installation folder. Share contains the data and examples. Lib contains static libraries. Include contains Jiang 4 header files from the source. Bin contains the dynamic linked libraries. There is a nice explanation about the difference between a static library and a dynamic library. Basically, we need the header files in the include directory and the static libraries in the lib directory to compile your own Gen4 application code. And we need the dynamic libraries in the bin directory to run them. To tell your Gen4 application where those headers and the libraries are located, you need to perform a post-install setup as the Gen4 installation guide calls it. You need to add the bin directory that contains the Gen4 dynamic linked libraries to your path environment variable. You also need to create other environment variables to point to the datasets saved in the share directory. To do that, click on the Windows logo, type in environment, and select edit the system environment variables. In the pop-up window, click on environment variables. As a normal user, we only need to deal with user variables and leave the system variables untouched. Double-click the path variable to edit it. Click new to add the path of our Gen4 bin directory. Click OK, OK, and OK to close all three windows. Your new setup can only take effect when you close all of them. The last thing we want to do is to add environment variables for datasets located in the share directory. There are many of them. Let's take the first one as an example. Click on the Windows logo, type in environment, and select edit the system environment variables. Select environment variables, click on new, and copy the data set name into this box, and copy the location of this directory into the box below. Click OK, OK, and OK to save your setting. It is a very slow process to add them one by one manually. That's why I wrote a Windows batch file called gen4.bat to add those environment variables automatically for you. You can download this file by right-click on the raw button, select Save Link As, and save this file to the place where your Gen4 data directory is located. If your browser blocked the downloading, click here and select Keep. In the pop-up window, select Show More and Keep Anyway. Go to your Gen4 data folder, double-click on the file you just downloaded. Hackers may use batch file to do all kinds of nasty things to your PC. That's why Windows keep warning you during the downloading and running process. If you trust my batch file, click on More Info and Run Anyway. A small window will pop up informing you that the environment variables are set successfully. Press any key to close this window. And now you can click on the Windows logo, type Environment, open the Edit System Environment Variable window, click on Environment Variables to verify that the Gen4 dataset variables are set properly for you. And that's it. Congratulations, you finish your first Gen4 compilation and installation in your Windows machine. Even if everything goes well, it will still cost you a few hours to finish the whole process. Unfortunately, Gen4 does not provide you a default application for you to double-click and run. The libraries in the bin directory cannot be run by double-clicking on it. To verify that your Gen4 installation is successful, you can download a Gen4 application called Gears from GitHub. The small executable is pre-compiled with the latest Visual Studio and Gen4 on Windows 10. Click on it and download it to your local machine. Open the folder, double-click on the program, and run it anyway. Hooray! You just launched your first Gen4 application. In the black window below, you can verify the Gen4 version. In the windows above, you can type in Gen4 macros and run your first Gen4 simulation. To quit Gears, type in exit. To learn more about Gears and Gen4, please visit the Gears homepage and my YouTube channel. Happy learning!